Sheriff, we'll just waive the preliminaries. Let's call this special meeting to order again, as I think Mrs. Roberts is ready to go. And Ms. Rhonda, are you ready? And Mrs. Herring, you ready to go? Well, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. All the staff's ready, board members, good. Again, welcome. This is a special meeting. As I previously said, we're going to address a Port Authority loan agreement, and we will St. Joseph Bay scholar season. Going that order, the first order of business will be the Port Authority loan agreement. Anyone? Butler, have anything, any input on this? We'll go directly to the board here.
Mr. Chairman, most time I know when to be quiet and when not. I can read a split board when I see it. But I just want to say this. The $199,000 that the county commission for the Port Authority, that was $99,000 that took us about 26 years to get back after we loaned it out the first time. And I'm not telling you today I was for handing that out, because on one hand, that chair of the Port Authority told us earlier this morning, we probably need more communications. We need to know what each other's doing. And I've been here a while and not necessarily know what Port Authority is doing. But so it makes it easier. It makes it easier to say, you know, let's hang on to that 199. But it didn't. County Commission loaned that 199 out. Later on, the Port Authority came back and asked for like another 120. And that was a little bit closer to me, because that 120 was derived from us leasing out the industrial park. And the industrial park, it came about due to Tropical Storm Alberto 1994. We was able to get a grant. And I was a major part of getting that grant, EDA grant. We got three that year. We asked the guy in 95. Got three grants, one for the marina here in Port St. Joe. One wound up being for the Gulf Coast Community College satellite building here in Port St. Joe, and one was the industrial park. And I had always looked at the revenue from that as somewhat of a nest egg. It's always good to have. If you're trying to do something, you want to be able to fall back on something from time to time. But once that nest egg was exposed, it was eat up. And so $120,000 of that was taken. And I'm not telling you I would did agree to that at that point in time, but the board loaned that out. But with that all said, and I know what everything all the board members said this morning, I think we're at the point in time where if the board doesn't do something, if the county commission does it forward, it's hard to give it $200,000. We have just gone through, and Mr. Chairman, you head the budget review committee. We're just going through and we are squeezing the budget again and not replacing some employees at Public Works. And we identified just a little better than a couple hundred thousand dollars that we can save by not putting people back on. But then somebody wants that $200,000. So it's hard to give up $199,000, hard to give up $120,000, hard to give up another $200,000. But where I think we are, if you give another 200 up, you're going to get all your money back in 3 years. If you don't give it up, it may stop any possibility of the Port Authority with these LOIs or whatever value they may be, may stop any potential businesses coming into town, whether they come or not. If they're not coming, they're not coming. But if they were coming, this may stop the opportunity of them coming into town. So if I had to make a recommendation, my recommendation last week at county commission meeting was, if you're going to loan another $200,000, I'd get something back tangible that you can do and get your money back. Right now, short of you foreclosing or short of someone foreclosing, you don't get your money back. This would be a prearranged agreement between the county commission and the Port Authority that in 3 years, there's no fight, there's no argument. it's an agreement that was agreed on today or in next day or two, that would allow you to get your money back without any disagreement on either side. So I just want to throw that out. It's hard to give 199 up. It's hard to give 120 up. It's hard to give this 200 up. But I'm looking at it may give a little breathing room for the Port Authority for the next 6 months and the next 3 years to do something. That otherwise, it may not help. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, thank you. Mr. Chairman, we just came out of a hour-long meeting over there concerning this. We heard from both sides. Some good points were brought out. I want to go back to Mr. Butler's comment on the $200,000. 26 years later, we got it back. We're saying 3 years later, we'll get this back. That's no guarantee. I've been here a long time. I've seen stuff happen. I've seen we get new commissioners on board. I've seen the votes change. So to get to $300,000 or $500,000, $600,000, whatever it is, say we're going to get it back in 3 years, guaranteed, there's no guarantee. But me personally, like I said, we've just walked out of an hour-long meeting with this. I am ready to move forward with this issue. I am prepared to put a motion on the table to deny this request. And let's sell it. I think there's other options out there for the port to go out and get the money. I'll say it again. St. Joe Company owns all the waterfront property. When they get ready to develop it, they will develop it, and they have the money to put it up. Let St. Joe Company put up $200,000, you know. Let the other counties, joining counties, put up the $200,000. We put up money. We have supported this project, I know, going on almost 16 years that I've been sitting on this board. So, and I have made a lot of the motions. I've always supported the port, tried to support them. But there comes a point in time when you have to step back, and I'm stepping back. So my motion is to deny this $200,000.
That's your motion?
Two.
I have a second to his, to Commissioner McLemore's motion. I have a second to his.
Well, I'll second for discussion.
By Commissioner Bryan for discussion, all right.
It's my understanding that we don't, and respectfully, Commissioner McLemore, I don't believe we need a motion to deny this request. If we need it, that's fine, but they've asked for something. I think if we don't have a motion at all, it just doesn't happen.
Just settles. Okay. I'm good with that too.
Unless Mr. Novak has a different.
Right. Thank you, Commissioner.
We don't take any.
I'll come right back here. Let me go here, Mr. Attorney.
To address the commissioner's question, they both have the same result. So no action is the same as a denial. You don't need an affirmative action. If there's no action of the board, I think that conveys the same message to the Port Authority. I just wanted to offer to the chairman and Commissioner McLemore the one comment with regards to the 26 years of the EDA money, and it took that long for the county to get it back. When I came on about the same time as the chairman was about the same time that money came back to the county. And the difference between the first EDA loan that came from that $200,000 over 20 years ago and what the county commission did 6 years ago was that we actually secured some collateral this time around. If you all recall, the money that was issued to the Port Authority was originally on the property that Capital City foreclosed on. And shortly after giving them that money, you had a second mortgage. The Port Authority came back and asked you to subordinate to work with Capital City Bank. They ultimately lost that property. In the process of losing that property, the county was then obviously exposed to not having that collateral. The county then was asked for additional funds, and you've now secured collateral against the Arizona Chemical site. So for 3 years or 10 years, the county still has a secured interest in some collateral, whereas they didn't in the past on this money. The first 200, the additional 120 and the interest that's accrued. So there is a secured interest for the county's taxpayers' money right now in the property that you have the first mortgage on. And so I just wanted to make that distinction.
Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Sir, you may.
Mr. Attorney, we understand this, that if we did or still have that lien, can we have something written up that guarantee us that they will not fight it? If we have to foreclose on it, that we'll have some teeth in it, that money, if we do, affected, and also our other property?
Yes. The short answer to that, Commissioner, is that I've discussed it with Mr. Gibson. The recommendation and discussions between the county and the Port Authority were that there would be a letter, there would be an interlocal agreement between the two entities. In addition to that, there would be a deed in lieu of foreclosure agreement reached between them and the county. So that 3 years goes by, if they default on that money and do not pay the county back the money that is owed in 3 years, that they, within a 90-day period, then the county would move with the agreement and with the interlocal agreement to foreclose on the property, and their property would be deeded over to the county to record a deed in the courthouse. And my understanding from the discussions with Mr. Gibson and the Port Authority is that they would agree to do that. In 3 years, if they don't have the ability to pay and they default, that property becomes the county's. The county then has the ability and the exclusive right to do what they will with it, which would be either to sell it or maintain the property. So that would be what the actions would be taken in 36 months.
Thank you. No, sir, you still
and
have
if,
it.
I'm just throwing this out. If the property is sold, whatever excess, the county's not trying to make any kind of, we just want our money back. If something happens, we want to guarantee we're going to get our money back. So if it happened to sell, I mean, if it happens to go to foreclosure and it happens to sell, any excess monies given back to the Port Authority, but our money plus interest come first.
Under a traditional foreclosure scenario, when you foreclose on a property, it would sell and then satisfy whatever the primary note was. So the county would have the first lien, and that would be satisfied. Anything over and above that, after they satisfied all their debts, would go to Port Authority. Under this scenario, the county would take the property, and as I understand from the discussions last week in your meeting, the last county commission meeting, is that you would sell the property, take what is owed to the taxpayers of Gulf County, and it was a discussion that the excess, as a typical foreclosure, would go to back to the Port Authority. So if it was $555,000 in 3 years from now, the property, if sold by the county, would take their money plus the interest, and the excess would go back to the Port Authority, just as it would under a typical foreclosure. There wouldn't be a windfall to the county of however much more the Port Authority would say the property was worth, of a couple hundred extra thousand dollars.
Bottom line is, that all, Commissioner? Bottom line, if we invest, we get it. If we don't, we get our money. Hold a first mortgage. All right, Mr. McLemore, you, let's go back over here to Commissioner Bryan. You seconded Commissioner McLemore's motion with discussion and raise a question whether we really needed a motion or not. Well, are you asking, or withdraw your motion?
Yeah, I withdraw my motion.
Any other motion?
I'll go ahead and make the motion. I spoke my mind over at the meeting, and I'll make the motion that we approve the loan agreement. Everything that Mr. Butler was talking about included in that agreement. That's my motion.
All right, Commissioner. Your motion. Do I have a second?
Second
by Commissioner Barnes. In favor granting our board the authority of the money. Okay. Any further board discussion?
I have a question.
Sure.
Where would this $200,000 come from?
Budget. About the middle of budget, smart budget. We don't have $200,000 just looking around in the desk drawer.
And that's exactly my point. We have things that we haven't funded that are our primary responsibility that we say that we don't have the funds for, so I'm very curious to know where this $200,000 would come from in the budget. How do we have $200,000 waiting to be spent this way when we have other county obligations that we haven't met?
Anyone else? Any other before I go to the audience?
Mr. Chairman, if I were to suggest, if you told me to try to find $200,000 to front, I'd probably recommend you look at your final settlement with BP. We still have $273,000 in that pot of money. So that would be one revenue stream that's not budgeted for something else.
But it's some reserve money we need. But anyone else? Anyone in the audience? Any questions, concerns before we go to the vote? Yes, yes, yes.
I know some of those funds were set aside for the issues at White City Boat Ramp. You know, these are critical issues. It's something that we don't know what the funding is going to be required there. The board already voted to fund the White City Boat Ramp, which is clearly falling into the water, and those issues need to be raised. And while I have the floor, I'm just going to raise my issues, Mr. Chairman, if that's okay. My other issue is, even if we went down this path with this deed in lieu, this board will still have to enforce that deed in lieu. And we're going to be in the same situation. Commissioner McDaniel, you mentioned that in that year we'll be in that, likely be in that same situation, and then this county commission is going to have to enforce that deed in lieu against the Port Authority. And that's a problem. Now, if this is a situation that this board decides they want to do and fund this request, I don't understand why we wouldn't take a deed now. Let the Port Authority deed the property to this board, and we can give them that same amount of time to 2019. They're able to redeem it. We will deed the property back. If they're able to cover the 575, the 200 plus the existing 375 plus interest, plus whatever cost the county incurs in this process, then they can redeem the property. If they find a buyer, or if the county finds a buyer, we're not looking for a windfall, but we would have what we've invested, what the county taxpayers have invested, we'd have that back, and the Port Authority will have that much time to sell the property or redeem what they owe, and we can have an agreement on the side for that. But the deed should take place now. We shouldn't have to wait for the deed.
All right, that's all. Anyone in the audience? All right, it's time we're going to vote. I'm going to go down each one. I ask, are you for the loan or are you against? Question. Commissioner Quinn, we'll start with you.
For.
For the loan.
I'm for.
Commissioner McLemore.
I'm against it, Mr. Chairman.
Against. Commissioner Barnes.
For.
For. Commissioner Bryan.
Against.
And the chair votes against. Motion passed 3-2.
Fail.
Do what?
Fail.
Yeah. That's right. You made the motion there and then failed. Anyway, we've been in this hour and a half. Motion failed. We support good luck. And our next order of business, ladies and gentlemen, very serious order of business, not that the one we just discussed wasn't serious. St. Joe Bay golf season. First of all, we have anybody from the state of Florida here? Got one gentleman over there. We have any concerned citizens about the closing debate?
No problem.
Keep your hands up. Let's see what we got. Thank you. It's my understanding. I didn't attend the meeting last, I think it was Wednesday, due to the fact that we have two or more commissioners together, come into a little thing called sunshine violations, and I understand I was called and briefed that it was a good turnout. It was some very good points discussed, and no decision made at that meeting. The representatives of the FWC were to go back to, I guess, to meet with their superiors, and we have a 60-day window, you might say, from May 1st through the 30th of June. Scallop season normally opens in, here in the last few years around July the 4th. But we're here today to see if we can get some more input and hopefully work with FWC on a solution. Because Gulf County, a lot invested in this. It's a lot of our promotions. I know a lot of the rental. I don't know if we have rental. I see one young lady out here has probably already had people lined up to come. Then they get a disappointment just out of the blue. We're closing the bay. Scallop's over. So it's going to be an economic impact right here, this area and to the entire county. So at this time, we're open to the St. Joe Bay scallop season. As usual, we go over to our county administrator. He's the one that does the legwork for this board. Mr. Butler, do you have any opening statements you'd like to make or any presentation before this board?
Mr. Chairman, you're detail of the meeting we had last week, last Wednesday night, it was good. It was right on point. It was a good meeting. It was well attended. We had a good group. It was not a confrontational meeting. Everyone in the meeting was trying to figure out how to make it work. And I think what it boils down to is there a way that we can, a compromise can be reached instead of saying we're going to close this bay, and with all the bad connotations made to go with that. Because when you say close the bay, it sounds real bad. The bay is, for other reasons, my understanding, shrimping has never been as good as it is now, or been a long time since it's been that well and good, and fishing. And so the only issue at hand is scallops, and for whatever reason, the county is low. But our encouragement to the board, and Mr. Attorney has worked up a draft resolution for the board to consider, is to encourage the state of Florida, encourage FWC to do whatever it got to do to mitigate the season, to whether it started later, during the weekends, a size limit on the scallops or something that would allow the bay to still be open for scalloping, so we don't go down the history saying that St. Joe Bay was closed for scalloping in 2016, but to give scallops a chance to grow, because earlier I think everyone in the room last Wednesday night agreed, late June and July is really too early. A lot of scallops are picked up. People sometimes not knowing, they're picking up scallops to get home. They can't shuck them out. They're so small and they go in the trash. And so is there something that the encouragement would be, our recommendation would be to try to encourage FWC to find a compromise to allow the bay to stay open. But do whatever we need to do in order to preserve the scallop.
Thank you.
Butler. For the board first. Why the people? I've asked two experts come here this morning representing Gulf County.
Yes, sir.
Commissioner.
Yes, sir. I'm going to address
it. Yield over to you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going to go into this in a little bit further detail than what most people are probably going to expect out of me. But here's my belief in it. Number one, I don't want to see the scallop season close. I think nature will take care of its own self there when nature will close its own self is what I'm trying to say. FWC don't need to come in here and close it. It's just like fishing, brim fishing up on the river up there. If we don't have the brim biting up there, you don't see the boats out there, especially out of the local people. Now, these tourists, most of these tourists that come down, all they want to do is let the kids get out there and jump in the water and find a starfish or whatever. But to say that we're going to close scallop season is going to be a disaster for this county with our tourism. It's going to be. Bay County over there, their tourism is down 41%. That's major. That's going to drift right on down if FWC implements this closing the bay for us. Guff County, I can assure you, is going to hurt. I already know some of the charter captains, their bookings are way down this year. We have people now that's calling and counseling. We have rentals that's counseling. The last thing we want to do is close this scallop season. That's the last thing. Nature will take its course. Scallops will come back. Now, what I would like to say on this, and hopefully the board will support me on this or whatever, but I fully believe this too, that we can help this. We have about 4 weeks of major until the scallop season gets here, 4 to 6 weeks or whatever. We need to take Miss Jenkins, we need to take her council people who sits on that board. They have worked this county for the last 4 years. They are a proven fact what they can do with tourism. We need to get in behind those people. If they need to dip into the reserves, y'all have money in reserves or whatever, to get in front of this before it gets bad. If we don't act on this now, I'm telling you, Guff County is going to hurt. And I think with that group of people, that's their business. I think with that group of people, they can put together a plan and get in front of this to minimize it as much as possible. So I wanted to say that. That's my belief. That's the way I feel. And I think it'll work. Hopefully it will work. We do nothing, tourism is falling, I can tell you.
Thank you, Commissioner. Any other members, anything? Sure, Mr.
I met with the attorney and also Dr. Hartman and Butler this last week, and we do have some options we can do. I'm with what? Let's don't close the bay. Panama City closed St. Andrews, never opened him back.
14 years ago.
Yeah. So let's don't do that. It's going to hurt our people. I mean, I'm for protecting natural resources. When I say not to close it now, we got some options. Maybe we can put it off 1st of August or something, maybe a little later, whatever the commission decides. But I'd like to hear something from some of the people. I know some here just in this meeting that there's a lot more about that bay than asking that. And I'd like to hear from them. I had asked the attorney just to kind of sketch us up something because Dr. Hartman and myself talked and all, and we got some very good alternatives.
Let me give just a brief here. I haven't scalloped in St. Joe Bay in probably 5 to 7 years. Used to be right regularly. You could go out there and spend all day and see very few people. We noticed, and with the people that live there, scallop with people that actually lived in the Simmons Bio area. We would go out, we knew what time of the day to go. We knew where to go. It wasn't in this area. we'd move to another area, we would finally locate them. They don't just, they, you know, they're not like road signs along the highway, just stay right here year round. They move around. You've got to search for them, hunt for them, and know when, what the water's doing, and when and how to go. But a lot more people out there. But I can take, I'll assure you, I can pick 10 locals and go out there and get more scallops than 200 tourists come out here. The tourists are not going to hurt them. Now, I was told that FWC went out and said they didn't find any. Well, I've got two local experts back here. If I send them out there, and they're going to go, they're not going to keep any. They're going to pick them up. But if they come back and tell me they're not out there, well, then I'll believe in them. But I've never had a lot of confidence in FWC. They've never been a very, they don't show a lot of conservation. They're tax collectors. They want to write you tickets for doing nothing. But we've got two people right over here. If they go out there in that bay, they know where to go. They may be right there on this side of Black's Island. They may be on the other side. They may be in. They may be out. You got to go locate them. You got to go when the water's right, when the tide's low. You got to know when to go and how to do and what to look for. But as far as it hurt me, I'll tell you this. I had a call from the Tallahassee Democrat. I said, the meeting will be taking place this afternoon. I don't intend to attend the meeting. I can't give you an answer. I said, but please, Tallahassee Democrat, please don't use the word close. Say we're looking at options. I said, use some other word. And they did. I respect the reporter. I can't even remember his name. But he did. You know, we were looking. There was no final decision made. We always scalloped in August. The reason it was moved back to July was because families come down with the children, school's out, and the kids can play. And like I say, they get out there with a little sand bucket, and they get them a sand dollar. But when the scallops, when we ran across them and they were only this size, we just went on to another area and located them. Now, what is the alternative to this? We could move the season back. The scallop, I understand through the biologist, that his life expectancy is somewhere between 12 to 18 months. I don't know that. That's what I've been told by the biologist. This scallop he pretty much spawns in the fall part of the year, the winter months. But they can grow. They grow fast. A July scallop versus an August scallop, there's a lot of difference in his size. A lot of difference in his size. I would like to see us move that date, maybe just shorten it for 1 month. Go down the size limit. You got a lot of options. Nothing west of Black's Island or nothing south of Black's Island if they want to restrict. A prime example here, we had the BP oil spill. I represent this county on the Apalachicola, Chattahoochee, and Flint River systems. We're in this water wars between the three states. I'm involved in it. I'm involved with the local six counties that border the Apalachicola River in the state of Florida. Fighting. We have a meeting this Friday. Gosh, FWC come over. The oil's going to kill them all. Go get them. They wiped out. That's one of the big things that happened in the Apalachicola Bay. They got wiped out. They over-harvested. Wiped out. They're trying to come back. Then they'd put them in this area. I've used this the other day we're talking about our good friends that's just bought all this St. Joe land, Desiree Cattle. They've got over 100,000 acres or more. Largest amount of their land in Gulf County. You can't put 10 cows on 1 acre of grass. You can put one cow on 10 acres, and you're going to have a cow, and you're going to have some grass. And that's the thing. It's called conservation and management. But I just personally, my own, and we're going to let people come up. I don't want to see this bay closed. It'll hurt thing. I don't want to see it. There's alternatives we can work together with. May not be 100% satisfactory to this group, but we can live with it. I just want to say that's what I want to do. I want to see if we can reach a good compromise. I don't want them to just walk in and say, your bay's closed, period. Boom, that's it. That shows that they have a lot of authority and they're not listening. They've already made up their mind what they're going to do. That's all I have to say. Ms. Jenkins, you're with the TDC. I have these other people. Anyone else on the board before I go out and give these people the opportunity? This is very important. This. All right.
I'll say something, Mr.
Thank you, sir.
I think you said, well said, Mr. Chairman, what you just said. And the word I was thinking about was compromise also. So hopefully FWC, people in Tallahassee will compromise with us and push back the season, do something so that we can kind of keep it open so we can keep the people coming in here to Gulf County. Because last thing we need is people to turn around and say, you know what, we're not coming to Gulf County anymore. You know, they close the scholarship season. So hopefully we can keep that bay open. Some kind of compromise with FWC, and we really appreciate FWC working with us. Let's go ahead and put this out. We're going to believe that they're going to work with us to keep the season open. We don't want to beat them up, but hopefully something good will come out of this scholarship season. Hopefully, like I say, we can compromise. They'll work with us and give the people a month, give them a week, give them something that they can look forward to here in Gulf County. So I think you did a fantastic job speaking,
sir,
on it.
Mr. Chairman, I just have one quick point. I just want to make sure that it's clear to folks that there's no discussion of closing the bay. The discussion is about the scallop season. So I don't ever want us to put out there that there's any issues with being on the bay. There's a lot to do on the bay. So we're strictly speaking about the scallop season. And I think there's a lot of great ideas, and hopefully FWC will work with us. We do need to protect the scallops. And I, at the meeting the other day, one of the issues that was discussed is the size limit. It appears to be the only species that you can go and take, and there's no size restriction. So I think that in and of itself, and even going forward, other than just this critical year, I think some of those things need to be in place.
Very good words. Why is the board through now? Right now, we'll come back. All right, let's go out into the audience.
Just to clarify a few things, and you're all correct. When the headline came out last week, FWC closing St. Joseph Bay for scallop season due to red tide. Red tide closing the bay is negative messaging. So regardless of what happens here, we're going to have to get in front of it. I met with my marketing committee last week. We have a meeting tomorrow. We're going to be talking about a rapid communications messaging plan. So it's not a crisis plan, but we need to get out regardless of what happens. I think we have to be really clear that should even if there's adjustments, this is going to be a 2 to 4 year cycle here. And every time I've spoken with FWC, they've reminded me of that. You know, they started the discussion, we may cancel the 2016 season, but it may also go on a couple more years after that. So for messaging, we just need to, it has to be anchored around, there's so much more to do on the bay, there's a lot of adventure out there, you know, come enjoy it. It can be a different twist of catch and release, and we just need to get out there sooner rather than later, because people are canceling and people are concerned. But we have support from the community to help get that message out. I'm not quite sure when they would make their announcement, but if it's right before July 1, that's going to be a little bit difficult because people are canceling today. So I've been in touch with FWC. I just got word that there's several meetings today. I just forwarded that to you, Mr. Butler, and I'm not sure what their decision will be, but they said that we should be getting a phone call this afternoon. But we are committed. The TDC, my marketing committee, met last week, and we'll be discussing plan A, B, and C, depending on what the wording is.
Thank you. There were several hands went up in the audience. We're hard here, there, whichever one. Let's come over here. Anyone on this side? All right, we'll get you back. Anyone on this side over here? Let's go over here. All right, I see one. Anyone else? I think we probably covered a lot of. We got another one there. Thank you, David. Pat, come on up.
Pat Hardman, Coastal Community Association. We certainly appreciate y'all having this meeting this morning and taking this up. We encourage you to pass a resolution this morning that we can get to the state officials to try to get ahead of this as well. closing the bay for scallop season has such a negative connotation, as Carmen has pointed out, and everybody else. And governments tend to work in an all-or-nothing situation, which what FWC tends to do. What we're asking them to do is to come off of, we can't do anything at all, and come back to some compromises. And the resolution, I think, will give them sufficient compromises to allow them to give us some language that we can have the bay open. Also, we are asking that that they said they had some funding that they could bring to the replenishment side of bringing scallops back into the bay. And so we're going to ask them to keep that on the burner as well as working with local people to bring that as an industry, basically. We talk about jobs, to bring that here so not only will we be able to prevent this type of thing happening in the future, wherever else it happens, we could also help prevent by having the scallops available to put out into the bays and the harbors. I tried to get them to at the meeting to tell me when they would reopen or what count would they give us to reopen, and they wouldn't, which scares the pleurity fool out of me. St. Andrew's Bay has been closed for 14 years. They tell me there's plenty of scallop, but they aren't going to reopen. If they are monitoring, if they are helping us replenish, if they're limiting what's coming out, and the size limit, the bag limit, the shorter season, and looking and giving us some numbers, I think that makes a lot of sense. It is a compromise. Whether we can get in front of them, whether they will listen to y'all, your efforts are going to be greatly appreciated by the people in this county to make the effort of not just saying we all do what you want to us, but it's our county and y'all representing us, and I think that's a big issue. If people are going to council because they can't scallop, the question would be, where are they going to go to scallop? I understand McCullough has about the same count we do. I think you got to go further south to get some. I've scalloped in all those areas. It's not like scalloping in this bay. You don't take children out at Steinhatchee and McCullough and what have you. That's some dangerous water. It's high, it's deeper. It's more difficult. It has currents. And where are you going to stay if you go over there? So one of the messages is there might not be plentiful here, but they're easy and child friendly here, where we can go out and see them and what have you. So all I'm saying is, let's try to get this resolution out. Let's try to get it up to Tallahassee. I know there are meetings going on with them. I know they're at least now not locked into, no, we ain't going to do it. Halsey Bashirs has said he will go on our behalf to try to do it, and I think he's sent some of those FWC meetings today. So if we can get a resolution out of here and get it to Tallahassee, I think it would do us a world of good, and we do appreciate y'all.
Well, thank you. Good morning, David.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Chairman, David Warner. I'm a bed tax collector and also the chairman of the Gulf County TDC. Thank you for taking the time to have this meeting. I want to congratulate you for being fairly consistent in your message. It's nice to see a commission kind of pulling together. I really appreciate the confidence that y'all have in the TDC and the work we've done. Thank you, Commissioner, for your comments. We've worked very hard to do good work. We're charged with a certain task, and I think that with Jennifer's leadership and her work and her team, we've been very successful doing that. This is a big challenge. This is a challenge, and it's a lose-lose situation. Talking about the conflict between economic prosperity and a natural resource that is obviously challenged. A couple things that came up in the meeting the other day. First of all, we have six of our board members here, so we're very, very dedicated to the work of the TDC, and I wanted to point that out. We have six of us here today. There were some concerns about the fact they'd had their minds made up. Dr. Hartman said it very, very well, that government action typically is all or nothing. And I pointed out the fact that they had somehow leaked an article to the Tallahassee Democrat that was tweeted out that day that basically said their minds were made up and they had closed the bay, which is they agreed was incorrect and was a mistake, and they were going to fix that. And they also determined that it was red tide, and we hadn't heard anything about that. And I asked them what they were doing about red tide, and they gave me a story. Red tide's very hard to figure out. They did, at the end of the meeting, scratch their heads a little bit and say, we heard a lot of things that we had never heard before from our audience. We have some intelligent people here. We have some very experienced people with that bay. Compromise is something that I think that is an option that your resolution ought to include. All people want is a chance. Dusty May said it the best. He said, all people want is a chance to go swim around that bay and get a chance to go out there. You can't just tell them you can't go. And if you tell them you can't go, they're not going to come. I've had cancellations. I didn't expect that I would have them so quickly. I've had cancellations. I know that the other collectors, vacation rental businesses have had cancellations. I talked to a gentleman this morning who was a contractor from Tallahassee. He said, yeah, I heard that. That's going to be a disaster for y'all. He's from Tallahassee. I know another friend here in town got a text message from a gentleman in Perry last week. Said, what's going on? ! So the word's getting out, even though no decision's been made. And I think that Jennifer's right. We need to get ahead of this. We appreciate your support on us getting ahead of this with some emergency funding. Y'all make those decisions. So I think the message is the bay is not closed. I think the message is we're working on a compromise. I'm a little concerned the fact that, and I do understand the SPAT science. It was very, very extremely low. However, they've always made this decision that I can recall based on the June count. It's not even June yet. Do the June count, come back, let's talk again about this thing, and let's try to come up with a compromise where we can allow people to go out there and at least enjoy swimming around that bay, picking up starfish, because when I was a kid, I'd rather pick up a starfish than a scallop. They might bite me. Starfish ain't gonna bite me. So, I that's what they want to do with these kids, and they want to go out and swim around the bay. There are people that are meat hunters. They go out there and they fill their 10-pound bag, and they do it 4 or 5 times a week while they're here, and they go back and they fill their freezer for the summer. Size limits, bag limits will eliminate that. Shrinking to certain weekends, pushing the season back, which our locals have tried to do. I think Debbie that pointed out at the meeting the other day that she has notes all the way back to 2001 where the citizens of Gulf County have asked over and over the FWC push the season back, and they keep pushing it up against our request, and now they're going, the populations have shrunk. Well, maybe that's the reason why. So I would like to congratulate, or at least thank the FWC for listening. It's a new FWC. We have some commissioners on there that are friends of ours here in this county. And I've spoken to two of them. They are willing to listen. So whatever y'all send up their way, they're going to probably listen to you a little bit. So thank you for taking the time.
David,
yes,
thank
sir.
You. Those were very good words.
Any questions?
Presented. Any questions to Warren?
Thank you.
I still say here was a key right over here, Commissioner Quinn, the word compromise, and I want to commend you.
Yeah, you did you want to say something?
You
I just want to reiterate just a little bit. You know, we're going to lean on your people. I am.
Okay.
Y'all have proven to me what you can do.
Thank you.
Ms. Jenkins, her staff, your business people. Okay. 4 years ago, we didn't have what we have today with tourism.
Yeah.
You're the people that made that happen. You're the people.
With y'all's help and
that's
support.
Right. That's exactly right. But
yeah.
Right now, where we're at today, if anybody can get us out of some of this, make it easier as possible, it's you people. FWC has already done the damage, a lot of the damage. Just that article the other day over in the Tallahassee Democrat, I've had phone calls from out of town.
Mm-hmm.
We've got cancellations. Our only hope is for you people, let's support you people, get in behind you, and do what you can do to help save as much of it as we possibly can.
Yeah, one, I just, real quickly, Allison pointed out a good fact. My one cancel, or my few cancellations that I had were regulars that come here from Destin every year, and they bring a bunch of people. It was in August. And August is when most people have said would probably be a good time, if we're going to compromise, a good time to have a season open. I'd love to call them back and say, hey, you can still come in August. And might get some, might not, but you're still going to have a good time here. So, thank y'all.
Thank you, as always. All right, we're still on this side of the room. All right, thank you. Switch over here. We've got, how many we got? Come up, have some, we'll probably answer the other's questions. We've got two over here. As you would, let me go back here and Doug, let me ask you to come up, please. Next. How's retirement life?
I like it.
You do?
I like it.
Good morning to you, Doug.
How y'all doing?
Give her your name, not she don't know you.
Hey,
you have a floor, Doug.
What we need to do, in my opinion, is you need to open it in August and let it run September 24th, just like it does for this year. That's 54 days, I believe. Those scallops right now are very small. I scout all of June when I go, and they'll get the count will be a lot bigger in August. I mean, I've seen some go as high as 54 count. That's the highest I've ever seen. That was late August, early September. June, you count them, they're like 120, 140. They look like pencil erasers. You get a lot of people in there early, and even though they don't pick up this much, you multiply that time 1,000 people, that's a lot of scallops toted out that would have hopefully matured. And I just believe if we'll open it up later, it'll all be better. And those people that don't come down here to council, that council these people's business, I believe they'll come back. When the word gets back out that scallops is here, they'll come back. Because you see people during fireworks, the place is full of people. So I don't think you'd have to worry about that much. I just think if they send something up there where you can open it in August, 1st of August, whatever, and let it just run its course, and let's see. But don't jump the gun and just close it. Because if you close it, you might not never get it back.
May I comment, Mr. Chairman?
Doug, just hold still. Phrase his.
I just want to comment for the record, and everybody knows me. This man right here, he is the daddy of scallop.
I don't know about that.
Down here. If there's anything about a scallop in St. Joseph Bay, this man knows it. And I will listen to him. If he recommends to open it in August, I will support that 110%.
I appreciate it, Coach.
I know you're an old timer, just like me on that river up there. I know a little bit about the river. But you know this scallop, no doubt.
Yeah, we went a few times.
Yeah.
But I just think that's the best thing. I know there'll probably be some people disagree with me, but I'm telling you go out there this time of year. I went last Wednesday and just checked just to see if you could even get a count. And we picked up 14, and they was like a nickel, dime, and a quarter. And I'll tell you something else. The state's count, now I'm not talking about the spat, I'm talking about the scallop itself, where they do their count on a 60-meter line. Well, I seen them do it last year, because I was scouting. And where they was at, they was in grass this high. How they even seen one, I don't know. But I've always seen them on them flats. They lay up on them flats, they real little, and as they start to grow, you got about 2 or 3 moons, full moons coming between now and July. And they get bigger every moon. And I'm telling you, the end of August, in the first part of September, there's certain places out there you can go that they find. I'm talking about like that big old chunk of meat in them. You can go to some other places that they don't grow that good. You know, it's just, I don't know what it is. But I'm telling you, I believe everybody would fare better if you opened it on August. If they would do that. I don't know if they'll do that or not, but because personally, when I was up here the other night, they seemed like they had their mind already made up. This was just a formality. So maybe it'll have something. Maybe y'all can do something.
Doug, do this. I know you will. Won't you? Keep any. Get us all in trouble. Won't you go out there? You'll do it because you're a native Gulf Countyan. You got a deep heart. And then back out there and do you some spot checking. You know, sometimes they'll be over here on this side. Sometimes they may be over there. They move around. And just and come back here in about a month and let us know what you see. You'll do it. Carry you. Sidekick Larry with you.
I usually start Memorial Weekend.
But dude, just go look. You know, don't care. You can pick him up and look at him, measure him, throw him back. But don't put him in the boat now. You'll be in
trouble. We're going to go look at him. Maybe y'all can get them to listen to you a little bit. And,
hopefully. You know, hopefully.
I believe it'll help everybody.
All right. Thank you, Doug. Thank you always.
Thank you.
All right, I got Reggie here, but Reggie, will you yield to her or you want to come on up? All right, come on up.
I just want to clarify one thing. I'm sorry.
All right, she's already spoken one time, but this is important.
The last few years, if you recall, the way that the rules are with the beginning of the season, if July 1 isn't on a Saturday, they open up the Saturday before.
So they open up in June.
So last year was the 24th this year. If it does stay, in fact, it is the 25th this year. So you get those weeks right leading into 4th of July where we're at capacity. And so fundamentally, if we can move the season back, you know, forever. When we went to meet with FWC last year, that was one of the key issues and one of the reasons why we came.
It was.
So I agree with moving it, but that was that the last 3 years it's been open in June.
I agree with you. Thank you. All right. Reggie, thank you. Come on up, sir.
Yeah, let's wrap this up. But mostly things I can say is already been said, just reiterating a couple of things. And then now I came in at the last part of the meeting the other night, and they stated, y'all correct me if I'm wrong, but they stated that they would be coming back to discuss again. But when they come back, good chance the mine's already made up if it hadn't been already done so. So I guess we're talking about doing a resolution type thing, right? All right. First thing is accidentally, not on purpose, it's already been stated several times about bay closing. And it's not that, and it's been brought back up that we're not, that's not what it is. It's scallops. So. Anyway, like you already said, FWC, along with the media, has already heard us initially. But like Ms. Pat and Mr. Warner both said, the all for nothing thing, I say that the resolution, we need to put as much into that, offer them as much as we can, if we feel necessary, for them to lean our way, which I think personally would be to put size limit in there, bag limit in there, shorter season in there. And like you say, you get one shot. That's all you're going to get is one shot, one resolution or whatever. So I think everything that we can and feel that's right to do needs to be put in there initially, because it's not going to be a bidding situation. It's a one-time deal. Now, Ms. Pat, she mentioned about the replenishing in jobs and stuff, and that's good. That's a good discussion the other night, a good thing to bring up. I'm not sure that, just my thinking just right now is not, I'm not sure that that would need to be in the resolution, because it's kind of a separate issue, and we don't want them, you know, we want to focus on the one thing, having a season of some type for our church. I guess the last thing I would have to say was, just like Carmen had said, would be to get behind TDC 100%, do whatever we have to do, whatever we need to do to support them, because like you say, they're our mainstay, and that's going to make all the difference in the world. But I just think we need to make sure that we address all those items, don't just put one or two things of why we would like to see some type of season. We need to throw everything at them we got at one time.
Thank you, Reggie. Thank you. Anyone else over here, young lady? While she's coming up, I think we're pretty much in agreement here, polling the audience. August, size limit, out of our resolution. I think everybody in here is on the same page. Do what? In a bag limit or whatever. Anyway, we don't want to send 50 things over there. We need to narrow it down to about three. Good morning to you. If you would, state your name over here to Ms. Roberts, and we'll go from there.
Okay, thank you.
Formality.
My name is Debbie Van Vliet, and I operate Happy Hours Kayak and Bike Outpost in the southeast corner of the bay for 16 years. But I'm always nervous up here at the podium. Forgive my shaky voice. But and again, I will not belay the recommendation that we've had ongoing for back to the year 2000 when we opened our business, and I have articles in the newspaper in the Star that support delaying the opening of the season to the August or Saturday before August time frame, and a 2-inch minimum. The FWC doesn't listen. What I have always observed is that the season is an economic season. The FWC doesn't really care about the scallop population. It's too small. They don't know about it. They don't care about it. And we have to do that. I was a little confused about the purpose of this meeting. I thought the FWC would be here. But obviously, this is a meeting for us to advise the FWC. Is that?
Well,
okay.
I thought they'd be here. The one gentleman raised his hand. He was. I see he's left the room.
Yeah,
so.
And he's from the state park.
Park.
So,
anyway, I knew he was a park ranger, but I didn't know if he was going to represent for them.
So if it is an economic season and they're not going to really regulate it, then the local people, like Doug Kelly and his sidekick and everybody, Dusty May's not here, but he was a great spokesman. I make my living underwater in St. Joseph Bay, and I've been doing that really for over 20 years. So, you know, I'm like the little mermaid down there, and I'm looking at everything besides scallops as well, because there's a lot more to see there than scallops. But it's an economic resource to us, but not to the FWC. So whoever called up Governor Rick Scott after the BP oil spill and said, let's change the opening to early May or whatever because of the economics of it to give Gulf County a boost, who was that person? Governor Rick Scott doesn't care about the scallops here. I'd like to know who told Governor Rick Scott to do that. We just need to talk to that person and tell that person to tell the FWC what to do.
Let me say this. FWC doesn't answer to the governor. They've got their own little world. And
well, maybe that was another misprint in the newspaper because
they
quoted
don't, they
him
don't answer directly to the governor. They're
early
under a commission
for
of their
the,
own.
Our economics. So how are we going to appeal to the FWC to listen to the local people who know a little bit more than they do about the scallops. Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyway, thank you. Anyone else before we wrap up here? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think this... Here we are. I was just saying, anyone else out here?
Come back.
Anyone else? We will. All right. Thank you. I think everybody was very positive what we had in here. I think we're all leaning in the same direction. I think we have the same ideas. That's good. All right. At this time, Mr. McLemore, do we like to?
Yes, I do want to, because I do feel that this is so critical for us.
Yeah.
Time-wise, to get out there, try to get out there in front of this and less the damage as much as possible. I don't even know if I have to do this, but I want to make sure it's before the board and the board's okay with it. But I would make a motion that we let Ms. Jenkins work with our administrator on some additional funds if be needed, and her staffing to let's sit down, let her sit down, let her get on top of this now. I mean, yesterday is too late. It's just something we have to move on now. And I don't want the funds to stop her for this. This is what I want. So do I need to make a motion on that, Mr. Attorney?
Is it within the TDC budget that you're seeking? You're asking for the TDC to work with the administrator to find additional funding?
I want her to work with the administrator wherever she needs to go to get the, get the funds. She has a good reserve. She's managed her money excellent. She has monies, but I would recommend that she works closely with Mr. Butler to find the funds to get started on this, whatever she needs to do.
They're going to need board to approve whatever they're going to do, but they can go out and come up with some proposals for you all to consider.
That's why I'm making a motion now. I don't want her to have to come back to the board. Timing is critical here. She has to be able right now to move forward with this.
I can say, Commissioner, I know that Ms. Jenkins and TDC have a budget in place for public information, for messaging, for signage, for their social media, I know for their regional and their national exposure. So if it's the messaging that you're looking for, I know they already have the appropriate funding in place. I know that the administration and the TDC can work to use that budget funds that they have already for it.
What I'm asking the board is let Ms. Jenkins work with our administrator on funding. I don't know the strategy that she's gonna put out there that her staff is gonna recommend. I don't know what it's going to cost to do that. You know, I don't have any idea. I just know that we need to get on top of this, and if she needs additional funding, she should have this board permission to get it. Not 3 weeks from now when it's too late. This is something that needs to be done now.
I'm a little bit confused here on the fact that we're going to work together, but, you know, this resolution, I don't think we have to send any money in this resolution.
That's confused. That's a different ballgame resolution. Okay. Right. Okay. This is two right. Different right. Apples in the pie.
Okay.
What my motion is to for this board to let Ms. Jenkins work with our county administrator and her council people up there, come up with a strategy plan, a plan of action on this, and if she needs additional funds, let them find it. They know where it's at. She has the reserve, she has a budget, but they don't need to wait a month and come back to us and ask permission for this. This is something that has to be done now. We've already hurt. So that's what I'm asking the board. That's my motion.
Already have the authority to do that?
I don't think so, no.
Jennifer, come up here in just a minute. Okay, all right, thank you. Let's go here and then we'll come here, okay, and then we'll go back over here, Reese.
Let's go home.
We go home. We got to settle this oyster business. scallop business. Okay, Don, right quick.
Okay, just to be clear, my understanding of what Mr. McMahon is saying is for the board to allow the money to be freed up out of reserve or wherever it may be to maybe get a message out that, well, no, we don't get out. We're trying to assure the people that the bay is still open, and please come down to Gulf County and probably to the markets. And I'm looking at Jennifer. She knows, and I don't necessarily know, but I think what you're saying is if we need to get the message out other places, whether it be Nashville or wherever, you say we're open for business.
Yes, and like I said, if she needs to go to the reserves, that's where she needs to work with you, Mr. Butler. If she has the monies in her budget, that's where she needs to work with y'all, with you. But this board don't need to stand in her way at this point in time.
Just to put a punctuation in that sentence, my most of my marketing dollars for this current fiscal year have been expended because we've done prime season. We typically do not get heavy messaging out in the summertime. So I think when we come up with a plan with my council, I do not know what the cost will be or what that will look like, but it's not like I'm taking monies that I already had planned to advertise for summertime because they've been expended, and that's why we had such a successful spring. So I think that's what you're trying to say, Commissioner, is that should we put a plan together and not have to wait to the end of May to come in front of you all again, and I could execute under Don's direction.
Absolutely. Mr. Butler can authorize up to $50,000 just right off the table. He can do that on his own. You don't have to get permission from this board. Okay. So I think that should be fair.
We got to work with TDC. We don't have any. All right. Okay, I think now.
I'm done.
Back up.
I have a motion.
My motion is.
Then TDC to work with it.
You want me to clear it up? I need to clear it.
You need to clear it up?
No. You know what it is.
Good.
Would you read it back to me, please?
All right, we can go with that. I hear a second on the commissioner's motion for this.
Second.
We got one over here by Commissioner Barnes. Any further board discussion? Anyone in the audience have any discussion on this? If not, no opposition. This motion passed 5-0 for Ms. Jenkins and your staff back here, Mr. Warner. Thank you for everything to work with this. All right, now we're going into this. Reggie, you have, if it's on scallop, you already come up one time. And on there, we try to.
It was about his motion.
But it's cleared up. Mr. Attorney,
yes,
if you
Mr.
would, in the sake of time here, I think it would only be appropriate for the people that is televised and the people right out here, I want you to run over this resolution.
Yes, sir.
I mean, run over it. Read it. Read it
yes,
right
sir.
Here.
Yes, sir.
And in case the board wants to make some modifications or deletions.
And
would you please?
Yes, sir. And Mr. Butler and I have been making notes throughout your comments throughout
That's
this morning,
great.
So we'll have
That's
additional
great.
In there. It reads as follows as it was offered to you. The resolution of Gulf County Board of County Commission, State of Florida, supporting the protection of the St. Joseph Bay and its natural resources, including the stability of its scallop population through a cooperative state and local efforts with coordinated campaigns of preservation and public information to maintain and further promote the health of St. Joseph Bay for current and future generations. Whereas the Gulf County Board of County Commission seeks to continue its long and proud history of protecting its St. Joseph Bay, its ecosystem and marine life, and whereas the Commission also seeks to continue its long history of support of the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission and its efforts in Gulf County to protect and promote a healthy wildlife and its preservation. Whereas the citizens of this county, state, and region look to this commission for its continued leadership and support for the protection of St. Joseph Bay and its preservation for the current and future generations, and whereas the commission recognizes the FWC's research conducted by the Molluscan Fisheries Program, as well as the Wildlife Research Institute during the calendar year of 2015. Whereas on this day, May 3rd, 2016, Gulf County Board of County Commissioners duly organized under the laws of the state of Florida has properly met, convened and unanimously resolved in its unfettered support of the preservation of St. Joseph Bay, as well as the continued efforts from the FWC in its conservation and protection of Gulf County's molluscan fisheries. And now, therefore, be it resolved as follows. The Gulf County Board of County Commissioners pledges its continued cooperation and support of the FWC and its efforts for conservation and promotion of a healthy St. Joseph Bay. The Gulf County Board of County Commissioners, through its support of the FWC and its continued efforts and programs, urges a coordinated and cooperative effort to promote the health of the Bay and its mollusk and fisheries through public information campaign, both locally, regionally, and statewide, to achieve a balance between preserving these natural resources and maintaining the fragile economic stability of Gulf County's small rural economy through a balanced approach of maintenance, enforcement, and public information for the citizens of Gulf County and its many seasonal visitors from the surrounding region. The Gulf County Board of County Commissioners, in its unanimous resolution of support, strongly recommends and encourages the cooperation and assistance of the FWC in keeping open the waters of St. Joseph Bay for the 2016 summer season for recreational scallop and to achieve the balance sought by this commission on behalf of Gulf County, and to use the issue and the current data as the opportunity to educate the many visitors to St. Joe Bay this coming season. The Gulf County Board of County Commissioners offers in its efforts to achieve this balance of all economic and environmental interests the following additional possible considerations for implementing a public campaign of both the local and state agencies for, quote, Save the Scallops of St. Joseph Bay, which I think the TDC has already started to develop this campaign. In meeting with Mr. Butler and Mr. Barnes, as well as Dr. Hardman, and all the discussion today, we can begin to fill that in, which you've all discussed, which are size limit, shorten the season, push the season back, bag limits, a proactive information campaign from both the TDC and the state, educate the scalloping visitors to the county, messaging along with licensing throughout the summer, what are the programs for sustainable future for the fisheries, also revisit the spat count in June and make further evaluations on the season, pushing it into August, weekends only, also about public information for seagrass beds protection and prop scarring in addition to campaigning and signage, as well as others that you've discussed today. That a copy of this resolution be provided to all elected officials representing Gulf County and its elected Board of County Commissioners within the Florida executive and legislative branches, as well as the United States Congress. This resolution is adopted this day of May 3rd, 2016. It's set up for each of the commissioners' signatures, and we can get that out. So that's as we have it, making notes of all the suggestions you receive from the public, as well as from the commission and your staff today, which we will incorporate, and any additionals that you'd ask us to include.
Okay. Commissioner Quinn, do you have any anything you'd like to add or delete?
No, sir. I think everything sounds good.
Commissioner McLemore?
I just want to pass it and move forward.
Cool. Let's go, Commissioner Ryan.
I just had the comment on item three with the 2016 summer season that it should be summer scallop season, but I believe it's one of that type of language there, but so that it's more.
Barnes, this is primarily in your district. Do you have anything?
They brought up the open season back to either good August all or right maybe the first Saturday in August and lower size limit. We even had they encourage the people to chuck them in the bay because they got spats on the shells and eyes first and they jump them right back over. Probably help too. And second page.
Anything else, Commissioner? All right, the chair, I'm very satisfied with it. Attorney, have you got all this? You going to prepare this?
I will, sir, and I'll provide it to you all through Ms. Roberts for your signatures
okay
today so we can get it up to Tallahassee.
Yeah, let's get a motion for this resolution. We got our motion over here by Commissioner Barnes.
I'll second.
We got us. Thank you, Commissioner Bryan. A second. Any further board discussion on us forwarding this resolution to FWC? Anyone in the audience, any concerns, questions? If not, this motion with no opposition passes 5-0. Mr. Attorney, let's get to work on it, get the signatures. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for your concerns. And if we have any other business, Mr. Attorney?
In the interest of time and getting this to Tallahassee with FWC meeting today, I would ask, I believe it would be strong message if you all signed. Unless you're all available in the next hour to be around, I'm just going to ask for the amendment.
Can you have us sign it now?
I'm going to have the amendment made that the chairman signs on behalf of the commission, and it says it's a unanimous vote. So as long as I have that permission to amend it.
Do you need the signatures of the five?
I don't have it finalized, sir, so I have to go back to those amendments to it.
Kevin's going to do it.
So I'm just going to have the chairman sign as long as you all.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Thank you.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, that's pretty much it for this morning. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Captain Michael.
Second.